We want to solve the given log equations. To do this, since the log equations contain a single log, we'll write the log equations as exponential equations and then solve for x. So to write the log equations as exponential equations, we can use our notes given here below to identify the base, the exponent, and the number to form the exponential equation. Or if we identify the base of the log equation, we can work our way around the equal sign to form the exponential equation. For example, in the first log equation, notice how the base is 3, and therefore the exponential equation will be 3 raised to the power of 4 must equal 5x minus 3. So the base is 3, the exponent is 4, and the number is 5x minus 3. So we'll solve this for x. 3 to the fourth is equal to 81. Add 3 to both sides. We have 84 equals 5x, so now we'll divide both sides by 5. So we have x equals 84 fifths. This does not simplify. Let's go and just switch the order here and say x equals 84 fifths. Let's take a look at our second equation. Notice in this log equation, 2 is the base. So the exponential equation would be 2 raised to the fifth power must equal x squared. So 2 is the base, 5 is the exponent, and it must equal x squared. Well, 2 to the fifth is equal to 32, so we have 32 equals x squared. Now we're solving for x, so we'll take the square root of both sides of the equation. Starting on the right side, the square root of x squared is actually the absolute value of x, which means x can be either positive or negative. So we'll go ahead and include a plus or minus here on the left to make sure we get both solutions to this equation. So with this plus or minus here, we can say the square root of x squared is equal to x. On the left, we have plus or minus the square root of 32. Because 32 does have a perfect square factor of 16, this will simplify. We can write 32 as 16 times 2. So we're going to have x equals plus or minus 4 square root 2. Now we might be thinking that the number part of the logarithm must be greater than 0, so x can't be negative. But because this is x squared, we do have two solutions, both a positive and negative value for x. So again, let's go ahead and rewrite this as x equals plus or minus 4 square root 2. Okay, I hope you found this helpful.